Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about digital smile design, TPS, DSD, TPS, which stands for Treatment Planning Service. Basically, if you are a general dentist, restorative dentist, prosthodontist, periodontist, anything but an orthodontist for the most part, you might want to consider using this service. They have, not so recently, maybe in the next year, last year's two, or maybe more, they have partnered with Invisalign, not really sure how that relationship works. And now, basically, if you are looking, a lot of dentists, especially restorative dentists, the reason for them to do Invisalign is to have better restorations, better position, better aesthetics, better function. That's the reason they're doing Invisalign. They're not doing Invisalign just to have straight teeth. They're doing it so that they can do a better restoration on their patient. Because nobody wants to place a veneer and have it break off, you know, or look bad. Nobody wants to place an implant and have it not function or not take because the occlusion is bad. So basically the process is that you're going to go, and this is all I could find, to be really honest. I did contact DSD. I contacted CEO of DSD. I contacted quite a lot of people at DSD. So far, no response, but granted, it's only been a few days. So certainly if they do respond to me, and a lot of times people do, once they see me post something favorable up on YouTube. And by the way, this is their website. So people at DSD, if you don't like what I did or what I said here, or something was erroneous, you're more than welcome to contact me. As always, as with any YouTube video I post, this is just a phishing YouTube video. I'm just putting out some information because you guys are asking about it. And clearly the information is not clear to the dentist about how this works because they're asking me for help. And then hopefully DSD will contact me and I can make more content videos on how this works because I don't really know. So I have seen a few cases. I've had a few doctors who come to me with cases and it looks pretty slick. So obviously it's not something I'm going to do because I'm an orthodontist and I'm not doing restorations. So I'm just moving the teeth. I'm sure there's a way that if I had a referring dentist that all three of us could be on board and we could get DSD involved. Obviously, I'm not paying the DSD fee. That's the dentist who's doing it. So one of my doctors told me the fee is pretty high. It's about $400 to $500. I don't know if that's true or not. I was like, whoa, that's really, really high for smile design. But then again, and that's not even paying for the restorations. You know, that's just the design component of it. But not really sure if that's true or not. So feel free to reach out to me in the comments section if you're using DSD and let me know what your fee is. I would love to know. And this is literally all the information I could follow on their website. You click the learn more and they just take your contact information. I guess they get back to you. So I'll probably fill that out too, see what happens. But basically, yeah, the way it was described to me is that it's reverse engineering. So basically, you know that you're going to want some veneers on top. You don't know if you need 4, 6, 2, 10. And you know that you need to set up this case so that the staging works to optimize the veneers. Do I need overjet? Do I need overbite? Do I need IPR? Basically, once you tell them kind of what you're looking for, DSD communicates with the Invisalign techs to come up with the best possible setup. And then the ClinCheck is designed around that, you know. And then I'm guessing at the end, you're committed to purchasing the restorations from them. I don't really know how that works, how you pay for it, what the deposits are, anything like that. But like I said, it's pretty slick. Now, there is other options if you don't want to use DSD. I don't think that they will communicate directly with the technicians at Invisalign though. So now you're going to have to be the intermediary. So I've done other videos where I show you how to export STLs that you can send to your lab. Now, you're going to need to ask your lab if they accept those STLs from Align Tech. So that's the question. I've heard not all labs do. I've heard that it could be expensive to accept STLs from Align Tech and to design around it. So ask your lab if they do before you click that button. And I do know that when you do click that button, it does say if you do not proceed with the ClinCheck, that there might be a fee. So that's all it says. It's a little bit of an ominous. I do not know how much the fee is. So again, if anyone knows about this, go ahead and put it in the comments section. I'm certainly not wanting to take the risk on this. Although who knows, I might. If I know a patient is gonna continue, I might just go ahead and click it and see what happens. But as with Invisalign, usually they kind of threaten you and they don't always charge you things. So as long as you're a good doctor and you're doing a lot of volume, I don't think they're probably gonna charge you. But anyways, I think it's a cool option. If you know you're doing aesthetics, the other tip I have for you, if you know you're gonna do some type of big restorative case, a couple couple tips. Number one, always, always, always collect your deposit ahead of time on the restorative. I tell people that all the time. I don't care if it's two veneers, four veneers, whatever, correct, collect money up front for the restorations as a deposit, because I can't tell you how many times, at least as just a regular orthodontist, patient would come in, clearly had a Bolton discrepancy, clearly had peg laterals. We need to move around the spaces so that veneers can be placed on the laterals after treatment. I contact the general dentist. They say, yeah, they're going to do this. I want the space 1/3 mesial, 2/3 distal. Fine. Great. Yeah, we do that. Patients on board. They say they're on board. They sign that they're on board. We get to the end. We've distributed the space just as everyone told me to do. Looks nice. We're done. We're ready to debond. And patient says, oh, I changed my mind. Can I get that lower incisor out instead? Or can I get a ton of IPR instead? Or can I do sequential distalization instead so that we can close the spaces fully? And it's like, what? Now this takes me another year and a half to go the other direction. And that's so not healthy for the teeth to have to move them one way and then move them back the other way. And that's how you get root resorption. So I want my patients to be fully committed to their chosen treatment plan. So I love the idea of really cementing that treatment plan. And I mean, you could theoretically, you could totally charge the patient for an additional go around. Obviously, if you did Invisalign comprehensive, you're not gonna have another lab fee, but it's just your time. And it makes me nervous because I don't want to destroy the roots, right? But that's my one tip. Always get the treatment plan in writing. Obviously, I was doing treatment plan in writing, but I wasn't collecting a deposit because I'm not the one that's doing the restorations, right? So just a tip for you on that. Other tip I would do besides that is make sure you're taking your photos with the Invisalign photo uploader. That's an app that you can put on your phone. It's relatively new, not new, but kind of new. Not a lot of doctors are using it. A lot of them are still using DSLR cameras, which is, there's nothing wrong with that. But then without using the Invisalign photo uploader, which goes from your phone or a iPad or something in the practice, it's cool because it crops and orients the photos automatically, really convenient, uploads them automatically to the treatment planning program, to the ClinCheck, you know, up into the Invisalign portal. That's pretty slick how it does it, but it also has one added benefit that you might not be aware of. There is a widget on your ClinCheck that's called InFace, and it has like a little smiley face at the top. You'll see it. It's usually to the left of the occlusion button, which is into the right of the like the max man left right button, somewhere in there. Maybe your dashboard looks different than mine, but that's what mine looks like. If you use the Invisalign photo uploader, you can click that button, and what it'll actually do, it'll show you where the midline would be, what the teeth would look like if you proceed with that particular ClinCheck, which is like so helpful if it's a midline case, like, or let's say it's a vertical case with a deep bite and you're doing some absolute intrusion of incisors. You know, you want to see how gummy is the smile to begin with, and now what would it look like if we did some absolute intrusion in the incisors, or vice versa for an open bite case. I love that function because I'm like, okay, I got an open bite case. Yes, I got rid of the habit. I got rid of the tongue thrust with OMT ahead of time. Okay, I'm okay to go ahead and proceed with, you know, and I'm going to have to do some absolute intrusion of molars, some absolute extrusion of incisors, but I don't want this patient to look like a horse, you know? So how much gingival display? What is the percentage that I want of one versus the other? So that is granted, it's a hypothetical tool. It's not an absolute, so you can't promise the patient. Everyone's going to respond differently. But it's a nice gauge. It's a nice way to kind of help, not only help sell the case, but to give you some boundaries as to exactly what the movements are. Remember, I can't tell you this enough. Your technician is not an orthodontist. They probably have one or two international orthodontists on their team. But especially if you're a lower level doctor, you're not getting an orthodontist even looking at your case. All they're doing is driving the bus. You're telling them what they want. And if you don't tell them what they want, what you want exactly, like whenever I see a case, I'm telling them exactly what I want. I want IPR here. I don't want IPR here. I don't need IPR at all. Do not do any IPR. Okay, I've got crowding. This is how I want to resolve the crowding. I want to flare incisors. I don't want to flare incisors. I want to expand arches. I don't want to expand arches. I want to add IPR, but don't do round tripping. I want to add IPR, but do round tripping, you know? I want to extract an incisor. I want to distalize teeth. There's like five different ways that you can handle crowding. And if you do not tell a technician exactly how you want to do it, they're just going to guess. And most likely they're just going to expand a procline, which isn't always in the best interest of the patient. It can cause issues. Same thing with they're literally doing a puzzle. That's they're getting paid on, I'm sure, if I had to guess, they're getting paid on production. You know, they have a certain quota they have to meet, and they're just going to try to race through these cases, you know, as quick as possible. So I highly recommend that, you know, you check this out and that you really evaluate your cases and try to make them ideal. All right, hopefully this was helpful. Thank you.